My friends, welcome back to our channel. Today, we're gonna learn moment. We saw how the force affects particles. Now, let's see what happens when it acts upon a rigid body. What is a rigid body? Simply, it is a connection of infinite small particles. For example, a lever, a valve, or your even laptop. Now, let's think of a valve. To open it, you apply a force with your hand. Free body diagram of this picture will be like this, where forces show your fingers. The valve will rotate around its center point, which is bolt. Let's say that both forces are equal to each other. This means that we satisfied equilibrium conditions, and yet the valve still rotates. Then we can say that those equilibrium equations are not sufficient for a system or a rigid body to be in equilibrium. So, why does this rotation take place? Because there is a force that is acting at a distance from the particles in the valve. Think of it like this: when force acts at the top of the valve, it will move all the particles in its way, which are all the top particles. However, all of the particles are connected to each other, that is why others also move accordingly. The force F will rotate the valve around its center point at a distance r, and this rotation is called moment. The distance from the center to the force must always be perpendicular. In other words, moment F about c is equal to force times distance, and here the distance is equal to radius, and direction of moment is counterclockwise, which is the direction of rotation. Likewise, force F at the bottom also produces moment, and is also equal to force times distance, and the direction of a moment will be counterclockwise. I presume you might have already guessed what we need for an object not to rotate. It must have zero total moment at any given point. Let's go over what we have obtained so far. Sum of all forces in x direction must be zero. Sum of all forces in y direction must be zero, and finally, sum of all moments at a given point must be zero. With these three equations, we can almost do everything needed in static classes. These ones are the most important thing in this class, and it is essential for any other structure classes. The last thing we need to know to solve problems is supports. There are three most commonly used supports: roller support, pin support, and fixed support. Here are some examples of supports from real life. Example to the roller support, example to the pin support, example to the fixed support. Probably you might be thinking, what are differences? The main differences are reactions, that is, actions made by these supports. Roller support has only reaction in vertical direction. Pin support has reactions in vertical and horizontal directions. But remember, fixed support has not only force in vertical and horizontal directions, but also they have moment.
It's done! Yes!
Ooh.